Hello humans, and welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm Nathaniel Munoz, neurotic science fiction novelist, published poet, YouTuber, and now the CEO of the Munoz Publishing House. So, in the last two videos, I basically started a character creation series in which I went through my character creation template to basically help aid your character creation process. So, while we're on the topic of character creation, let's go to the second page of my character creation template. So on the second page of the character profile template, we start off with goals. Now, goals are one of the most crucial points in your novel to moving your plot forward. Without goals, there's no reason for your protagonist or any other character to do anything. They have to have some sort of motivation, some sort of aspiration, something that they want to accomplish. So your goals are very important. Now, with regards to goals, there are two types of goals, short-term goals and long-term goals. Now, short-term goals, as you probably could have guessed, are goals that don't play a major importance to your plot. However, there's still goals that your character wants to accomplish. So while this is not going to guide your initial plot forward, it could definitely help with the development of subplots and other areas of your novel such as that. With long-term goals, those are the essential goals that push your novel forward and help you create a plot that will basically empower your readers to continuing to want to read through your novel. Now, with these short-term and long-term goals, it's very important to realize that without them, your novel will not move forward and probably will not exist. So you need to give your characters some sort of goals, some sort of aspiration, some sort of mindset, so that way they're willing to be able to help you develop your novel. Because essentially, although you're the one writing the novel, if you develop your characters well enough, they'll be helping you write the novel because you'll be writing it with their mindset. And that is essentially what you want to do when creating your novel. Next on the list, we have the personality perceived by self and personality perceived by others. Now, this is very important because oftentimes how a character perceives himself is very different than how others perceive them. And this could ultimately affect how your novel runs down. So for example, if you have a character that's, they see themselves as very powerful, very mighty, but other people just see them as arrogant, that could definitely play an important role in how other people interact with them. But if you have a character that is, you know, very soft-spoken and quiet, and to them, they're just seeing themselves as being respectful. They don't want to, you know, give an unwanted opinion. They just want to respect the authority of who's in the room. But other people might see them as shy, timid, and afraid to take chances. It's all about how it's perceived. Now, that's not always the case. Sometimes somebody who is arrogant is perceived as arrogant. Sometimes somebody who is timid is perceived as timid. And that is perfectly fine. And you have to take this into account when you're creating your other characters, because your novel has more than one character and every character should react differently to different people, different situations. You don't want to have every character react in the same way, because then it's just a book with a bunch of clones, and nobody wants to read a book with a bunch of clones, unless, of course, that is the premise of your novel. But if that's not the premise of your novel, it's very unlikely that you're going to want a flat novel. The next two, we have self-esteem and ruled by. I'm going to go into these individually because both of them play a very important role. What is the self-esteem of your character? For those of you who don't know, your self-esteem is the emotional mindset of your character in relation to himself. How do they perceive themselves emotionally? Do they hold themselves to a high regard or not? And when writing your self-esteem of your character, you want to make sure that this is portrayed in how you write your character and how you develop your character. If your character has a high self-esteem, make sure you show it off. You want to make sure that the high self-esteem is displayed for all to see. If your character has a low self-esteem, then perhaps you want to also incorporate that too. That could be one of the driving forces and maybe a motivational factor for your character to get out of that mindset. But regardless, how your character perceives himself is crucial for your character. It's crucial for your readers to understand who your character is. Next, we have ruled by. And I put ruled by as a section in which you can write, or rather check, which factor controls your character's decisions. This is very important because, like I said, your characters are not all going to react the same way or have the same mindset inside them. You're going to want to make sure that if they're controlled by emotion, you check that box. If they're controlled by logic, past, choices, a force, or morals. Now, I put a force being very vague. If you want to, right next to it, you could write down what type of force, but force could simply be somebody else overseeing them, controlling them, or it could be, you know, for example, in Star Wars, the actual force. Whatever you prefer to pick, definitely you're going to want to make sure you incorporate that and make it visible to your reader, because one of the key points with this goals section is these are things that your reader has to know, but you can't tell them directly. You have to show this through how you build your character, through the description, through the dialogue, through their reactions and interactions with others. This goals section is what's displayed to help push your novel forward, and this is an aid section to aid you to better create the character that everybody wants to see. They want to see a character that's well thought out, well developed, and well motivated. They want to see someone who's a go-getter, or perhaps not. Somebody who's willing to take the risk, or perhaps not. Someone who knows what they want, or perhaps not. But regardless, if your character is or isn't, they want a character that it is clear that they are or are not. Therefore, having that said, this brings us to our next section, embarrassed by. In this section, I left it nice and vague because it's not really of that much importance. This is the one section in this goal section that doesn't play a key role. What's your character embarrassed by? And I simply put this as this doesn't apply to every single character because some characters do get embarrassed by certain things, and sometimes that might help you in maybe even providing a comic relief or just to put a one-liner or something that could push your novel forward or might play a key role if the shoe fits. But regardless, it's always good to have a section there because sometimes some characters require to be pushed out of their comfort zone and do something that they are embarrassed by or feel ashamed to do, for example, public speaking. Next on the second page, we have emotional characteristics. And with regards to emotional characteristics, these gear more to your character, him or herself, as opposed to the plot and moving the plot forward. So for the first two, I have strengths and weaknesses. Strengths, obviously things that your character's good at, things they excel in, you know, what is it that you want to highlight to your reader? Weaknesses, what are they bad at, what are their flaws? And ultimately, you could even throw in there, what is their fatal flaw? The flaw that leads to their demise at the end of the novel, if your character has that. Following, we have social characteristics, and this area is a little bit broad. You could basically implement whatever type of social characteristics you want to write, but with social characteristics, you want to make sure that it expresses how they interact, how they are in a social setting. What exactly is their mindset, expression, and dynamics outside of their own comfort zone? Are they an extrovert or introvert? How is it that they can be characterized to better help you express that characterization? Next, I put a little part that says, how do they deal with anger, sadness, conflict, change? Because ultimately, whatever is the driving force behind your novel, your character will probably be experiencing one or more of these, and that will motivate them to push your plot forward. Ultimately, how your character deals with these things will help you decide who your character is and what their reactions will be, who they will be and how they will interact with others. Because all these factors together express who your character is, and you want to make sure you have that concretely set up before you write your novel. Because if you yourself don't know how your character is going to react, then how are your readers expected to believe the reaction that you write? Now, I've been talking about motivational factors for quite a bit now, but I haven't exactly stated a part where you can directly write down what these motivational factors are. So, following this deals with section is a line where you can literally just write what those motivational factors are. Are they trying to save the damsel in distress? Are they trying to go after a quest? Are they on a journey to do something or accomplish something? What is their motivational factor, and what exactly is the goal that they're trying to accomplish? You're gonna write that down here. Following that, I put fears, because fears are often great motivational factors, or fears help to drive your character to or from their motivational factors. So you want to make sure you write down what their fears are, because this could help you further write and develop your novel and make your plot a little more interesting. Lastly, in this emotional characteristics section, what makes your character happy? So here you're going to write basically what factors can you implement to break up, for example, a scene that's a little too somber or conflictive or whatever. You know, for example, if your character just got bad news, what can another character do to make them happy? Could they bring them coffee, tea? You know, what items or things, or even people, which people can make them happy? What items can make them happy? Whatever that is, you're gonna write that down here because that plays a crucial role to breaking up any scene that is too somber, conflictive, or just drags on way too long. Lastly, in page two, we have the belief section. In the belief section, I believe to be crucial because oftentimes characters are not pushed forward by, you know, simply emotion or simply the factors around them. A lot of times who they are and what they believe in pushes them forward and how they react, how they act, etc. So first on the list, we have morals. Are they very laid back? Do they still honor the code of chivalry? What exactly are their morals and how does that play a role into your story? Secondly, how much do their beliefs matter to your plot? Because oftentimes you might put, oh yeah, their beliefs play a super important role. Everything in the novel is guided by their beliefs. But there might be times when this character, you don't even hear about their beliefs. They're such a minor character, their beliefs don't play any importance. And you're gonna wanna write that there. Following this, I have a section where you can write their religion, because ultimately what they believe in and what their religion is might further affect how they deal with things and how they react to scenes in your novel. So I put them all here alphabetically. I also put another section at the end, so that way if the religion or faith that your character believes in or practices is not directly expressed, you could write that in. So you have atheist, Baptist, Buddhist, Catholic, Christian, Hindu, Islam, Judaism, Mormon, Protestant, other, and not specified. So whatever your character believes in, you want to make sure that this is also expressed to your reader, because this will play a crucial part in helping your reader understand your character. And you might even be making up your own religion if you're writing a fantasy world. For example, you might be doing a knockoff of Greek mythology. You know, what if they're believing in, you know, the god of wind, the god of sun, god of rain, and suddenly, you know, you decide to give these gods different names. You can also write that in the other section. So that is why I left that there, because, you know, if you want to make it more realistic and put religions that already exist in today's world, you could add that there. But if you want to create your own and be a little bit inventive, as this is your story and you can do whatever with it you want, then definitely you're going to want to just throw that out there, and this is a good place that you could even organize that. So that's all I've got for you today. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, leave a like and comment down below. I post new videos on Mondays, and just so you know, this character template is available at my website at nathanielmunoz.com/templates, or the link for it will be down in the description below. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, ring that bell for post notifications. Thank you so much for watching, and God bless.